Alright, welcome to part 6 of AI-900, and we got interesting line of question in this series. If you have missed my previous parts, please do check it out. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do subscribe and press the bell. Okay, so I mark the keywords. So the keywords is machine learning type and approve or request. Alright, so as already mentioned, like whenever you see like grouping into something, right, yes or no, then you got to choose only one option, and one option should strike in your mind. If still in your mind you haven't guessed the right answer, which I'll reveal in few moments, I'll suggest please go back to my previous parts, because I have explained this concept many times and you need to be sure, because you will get this type of question in real world. So since it's approve or request, clustering can't be, because in the question nowhere it's related to traits or something patterns. So clustering is wrong. Classification definitely yes, because I have said grouping into yes or no or into some categories is classification. Regression can't be, because you are not predicting anything. So we'll lock classification as the correct option. Okay, this is one interesting question, and it's about extracting key insights from structured and unstructured data sources is a feature of. So this is a fill in the blanks. In real world you'll get a like drop down kind of thing, so you got to choose the correct option. So the first option is conversational AI. Is it related to talking or something? It's not, right? So conversational AI can't be. Anomaly detection, is it detecting any kind of credit card fraud or something like that, unusual things? No, then anomaly detection is also wrong. Knowledge mining, this looks to be the potential option, because it does the extracting key insights from structured and unstructured data. So let's look at the other options still. So last is computer vision. Absolutely not, this is not the role of computer vision. So we are left off with knowledge mining, and this is the correct option. Alright, this is a concept related to sentiment analysis, and you got to be clear before appearing in your exam. So the first statement is sentiment analysis returns sentiment labels and scores for the entire document. This is absolutely true. Next statement is sentiment analysis returns sentiments labels and scores for each and every sentence within a document. This is also true. It does. Next statement is confidence score value ranges from -1 to 1. This is false. This is because the value ranges from 0 to 1, not -1 to 1. So this is false. So these are the correct option for this. Okay, we got to choose Azure service. So the first statement is extract contact details from photocopies of business cards. So we got 3 drag and drop option. I will give you a tip, exam tip. So whenever you get extracting contact details from any kind of cards, alright, so that is form recognizer or any kind of form. So this is the correct option. Next is identifying commercial brands on social media post. Alright, as already mentioned, if you have come across my previous part, so this is the role of computer vision, right? So this can't be faced, because this is related to post, not any kind of portrait or any kind of human. It's written in the question, right? So straight away computer vision. Next is detect head gestures in real time. That is obvious, it's face, because detecting head gestures, so you got this keyword head gestures, so this face. So these are the correct option for this. Okay, this drag and drop is related to NLP, and this is very popular service for AI-900, so you got to prepare. So the first statement is classification of social media post as positive or negative. This is a no-brainer actually. So this is nothing but sentiment analysis. So next is real-time transcription of podcast dialogue into text. So this may be confusing, because there is a speech synthesis and speech recognition. So both looks to be correct if you have done a high level, but if you have got a little bit of deep understanding, then it might not be a problem, especially if you are preparing for data scientist. So let me clarify this one. especially this confusion and fuss. So note, the keyword is dialogues into text, right? This is the, you are not making anything, like, so whenever you are like converting anything into speech, so that is synthesis, right? Basic English language says like you're synthesizing, you're making, that is translating into speech, that is text to speech should be speech synthesis. So you're left out with speech recognition. So this is speech recognition, right? So this is how you eliminate if you even don't know the answers. So this is the trick you should even apply in your exam as well. But make sure that you select the correct options first. So conversation of text to speech, this is the keyword text to speech. So I know this is speech synthesis. So this is the correct option for this. Okay, this is related to conversation, and as the question reads, so the first option is object detection. So object detection, definitely not. This is nowhere related to conversation, right? So this is a distractor. Next is computer vision. Again, computer vision is not related to any kind of conversation. Like it can detect brands, especially as mentioned in my previous question, but still, so this is wrong. Next is web chat bot. Definitely web chat bot does conversation. For frequently asked question, this looks to be true, but let's still look at the other option. Next option is speech recognition. No, definitely not, like it doesn't, cannot do a conversation. So this is wrong. So we are left out with web chat bots, and this is the correct option for this. All right, you might see this type of question in exam. I highly suggest, like, please do not skip this one. So the question says, like, I'll read it out. When building a language understanding Lewis app, example must be added to intents. All right, so if you look at the options, the first option is definitely a no, because on already in the question it's related intents, and intents must be added to intents doesn't make any sense, right? So first option is definitely no. Next option is utterances seems to be the correct option, but let's still look at the other option. Next option is feature. Absolutely not. Features are nothing but hints, right? So this is not you require for the timing for to add in the intents. Let me clarify this with official documentation as well. So if you see under this, so you can see add an intent, a machine learned entity with an example of utterances, right? So you can see the keywords right there. Utterances is the correct option for this. All right, this is related to a real world exam question and application as well. Common use of bot. So the first option is to help identify the main points in a document uploaded by a customer. So this is not the work of a bot, but it is a work of, I can say, key phrase extraction, right? So this is wrong. Next is providing first line automated customer service to customers. So this looks to be true, because you might have seen in some websites, like they give you an inbuilt bot or chat, right, where you can ask any type of question and it gives overview of that question. Like you might not be requiring that specific answer or expecting that specific answer, but still it gives you a high level idea of that problem. So it does provide the first line of automated customer service. So we'll keep this, but let's still look if we can find a better option. So the next option is to help interpret an image uploaded by a customer. So this is an example of computer vision under object detection, I can say, because when you upload an image, it creates a bounding box by object detection, and using computer vision you can do that. So this is nowhere related to common use of bots. Next is to help prioritize customer emails by performing statistical analysis of the email's content. So absolutely not. This is example of text analytics. So this is again wrong. So we are left out with B, and this is the correct option for this. All right, this is an interesting question related to analyzing faces within an image. So we got to choose two options. So the first option is custom vision. Yes, it can analyze face, but that can be your own set of images. So it's like cannot do a generic thing. So let's see if we can get a better option. Next option is computer vision. This looks to be a good fit compared to custom vision, because in computer vision, as mentioned in the question, we are analyzing faces within an image, and there's no way related in the question saying that you got to pick your own custom set of images. So computer vision looks to be more appropriate option than custom vision. So you got to apply this type of tricks in your exam as well, because there might be better option than this. So we'll chalk A aside for the timing. So the next option is text analytics. No, text analytics is nowhere related to faces. So this is again a distractor. We are left out with face and computer vision. So there's one tip for your exam. Whenever you see images detecting faces, face will be an option. And for audio or like voice, so their speech should be one of your option, correct option. So remember this tip during the real world exam, you might get this type of question. So we'll lock this two as the correct option for this. All right, this is a drag and drop again, and we got to choose Azure services for that. First statement is enabling multilingual user experience on your corporate website. So you are trying to translate one language from another for user experience. From which of these you can do? Definitely you can do via text translator. So we'll log this for the timing. Finding out whether customers like your product from their online post. Okay, so see, we are left out with speech and text analytics. Definitely you can't do with speech. Like you can do it instead text analytics. There's nowhere related to voice or anything, you can see in the question. So we'll lock text analytics for this, and verifying and identifying speakers by their unique voice characteristics. So the keyword is unique voice characteristics. So speech fits here. So we'll lock speech as the correct option. So thank you so much, and we'll meet in DP900, which is most demanded and most requested in the comment section. And please don't go away, because I'll be uploading more videos related to AZ900 as well as AI900. So bear with me. So thank you so much for joining.